I can see that. I can see that. But who is he fighting against? Let's see. Our boy. We got a boy. Let's see. Eldin.
Right, I've seen that tag before. I've seen that tag somewhere around before.
However, he's Olimar. And I know Seagulljoe sometimes has issues against Olimar. I know logical seems to reach, but look at that.
Man. And I don't blame him, man. You know, Wolf is just combo food. And let's keep it real about the situation. Olimar, no short of comboing tools.
Yes, that is true. Olimar, I feel like he's a very slow character. I tried to play him. Mm-hmm. He's very slow. However, it doesn't matter. If you can just keep throwing stuff in your face and you can't punish it, you're going to have trouble. Look at that.
Yeah.
Seagulljoe, 66%, and Olimar, 0.
Oh, my
92,
goodness.
One F smash.
Throwing Shaniqua out at him. And, you know, to kind of add to that, you know, we don't want people at home thinking that, like, Olimar has bad buttons. What you mean is, like, he plays the slow game is what it is.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? His buttons are nice, but trust me, if he has to time you out, Olimar's going to do it, all right?
Oh, he'll have a good time, especially that white Pikmin that he keeps trying to throw on Seagulljoe. 109%. Seagulljoe only putting 11% on. He can't seem to get it. I feel like he needs to play a little bit more aggressive.
Yeah, man, it's hard because, you know, a lot of Wolves, you know, they like to use that neutral special and kind of retreat and dictate the tone of the match. But, I mean, you're kind of outclassed right now in terms of projectiles, man. Nobody could do it like Olimar.
Yep, that's true. And right now, again, Olimar trying to throw Pikmin instead of doing a smash attack. However, I feel like the best option, especially with that purple Pikmin right there.
That's
two
right.
Purple Pikmin. Just run up and hit him. There it is.
Speaking of getting ran up on, man, that backer clearing out that first stock. Eldin looking damn good here, man. Like you yep. say, you know, maybe not the most aggressive player in the world, but, man, it's all about dictating the tone of the match, man. He's doing just that.
He's doing a fantastic job at it. But right now, I love how Seagulljoe's jumping into those neutral airs. Those neutral airs will go through, like, up smashes coming out from Snake. And what? What was that?
Man, hit that man with the Swiffer web jet on the ledge, bro. Swept it up real good.
Oh, my gosh. Right now, Seagulljoe able to bring that back. He had a pretty big deficit. He was losing by, like, 100%, but he got that down smash at, like, 60 or so. So he's looking pretty good. However, I feel like he's starting to adapt against Eldin. Eldin needs to find a way to get this damage still like he did in the first game.
That's right.
Or first stock, but without taking damage himself.
He understands that the lead is not that big, so what he's going to do now, he's going to stay up here on this top platform, shoot neutral special just in case he decides to jump up and hit him with the aerial. He doesn't want to come back down to center stage because he's going to risk getting grabbed and comboed up at a very low percentage. You see right now. 49%, man. Seagulljoe just really struggling to stop the bleeding.
Yeah, it's like a whole 30 seconds without Seagulljoe even giving any sort of damage on Eldin. However, that one dash attack, 29% already, and now he's at the ledge. Let's see if he can do something about it.
Yeah, man, you know, the same formula Olimar kind of uses where, like, he gets, like, one grab or, like, one follow-up and it turns into mini hits. Wolf gets that same thing, too, man. It's just a lot harder for Wolf to get in at times.
Yes.
As you see, kind of stuck at the ledge, man, building up that wall, trying to force him back off stage. Now, we've seen Seagulljoe give the offstage pressure to Eldin, but we haven't quite seen Eldin return the favor yet, so I'm really excited to see what he's going to do out there.
I would not be surprised to see if Seagulljoe can bring us back already.
Oh,
he's
yeah.
only 20% down. You know he's going to go for that down smash, and there is one right there and an up smash just in case he can get that regular get up read. So, bang, he almost got it.
He did, man. But you know what, though? Even though he's missing a couple of his like, confirmations, he's brought this match much closer. Look at this. Separating him from his Pikmin, now it's forcing Eldin to have to go for parries.
I'm actually proud of him for actually using the laser because that laser can keep Olimar out without Olimar being able to throw Pikmin because that laser blocks the laser or blocks the Pikmin and also blocks Olimar's approach.
Man,
so you notice he's using it more.
Let's be real about it, K-Tarl. That laser is the best projectile in the
yes.
game. Free.
It's so annoying. If anything, the only thing better, wow, at that down smash, but the only thing better is the Nikita coming out from Snake. That's a really good edge guard tool, but that laser just keeps you out and you're like, how do I get it?
That's right. Absolutely.
So he's starting to use it more often. He feels like, I feel like he's starting to realize this works versus Olimar. However, it doesn't matter. Olimar getting that double jab into grab.
It is. You know, Seagulljoe needs to tap back into some more of that situational awareness that we've seen on that second stock, man, where he decided to stay up from the top platform and force Eldin to come to him. Eldin right now is up underneath him. And as history shows, no matter what smash game it is, if you're above your opponent, you're about to be in for a world of hurt.
That is true. However, right now, Seagulljoe. Oh, my goodness. Again, that F smash near lagless, so it's hard to punish. However, this Olimar able to regain stage control. If you can just get a couple more hits, like maybe 20 more percent, you might be able to get one good smash attack even from the center of the stage and get the KO. And wow.
That's right. Did you see, man? Now, he had the neutral get up scouted out off the ledge. Now, Eldin Tipton is doing a lot of rolling, but, man, he's on a roll right now, though. There's a forward smash. Lets him back on stage virtually scot-free. I hope that doesn't come back to bite him in the butt, man.
Yep. And right now, we see Eldin just going for smash attacks. He knows. Any smash attack could get the KO, especially with the blue, yellow, or red, or purple Pikmin. And he has, like, a red. He has a blue. He has a purple. He's looking for it.
There it is. 5% differential between both of these two players trying to take the center of the stage here. Okay, I like that. Seagulljoe playing it safe, trying to approach with short hop in there. He knows he can get quite a bit off of that.
However, I don't know how I feel about this approach right now. He's playing a little too patient. That's allowing Olimar to just throw out smash attacks. You see, smash attack, and... Okay, playing a little patient. I guess he's not getting grabbed, so I guess it's okay.
That's right.
Oh, okay, my
runs
God.
Right at Olden. Come on now. Using the game's new mechanics as advantage. I like that.
Wow. Just barely missing that F smash.
Oh, but no. Is that the blue? That's blue.
Is that the blue? Oh, my God. Eldin jumps in the air. Happy to get that blue up throw.
KO. Left right that there. Man black and blue, K-Taro. What the heck?
Left him black and blue, and he's sitting there with the white Pikmin ready to get it going on.
Now, I got to say, you know, for somebody being, you know, Seagulljoe's position, you can't be too disheartened. You know, you didn't have the strongest showing in that, you know, beginning of that game, but the way you brought that back, if he can tap into that in this next game, bro, who knows? We might be able to see a game number 3 if we're lucky.
I agree. He was able to bring it back so hard. He made it where he was catching up the whole rest of the game. However, that ending is where he fell apart, and I feel like he needs to be able to figure out how to start, where he brought it back, he needs to be able to do that in the beginning. So you can get the lead, and it's like, all right, I just win it.
Yeah.
You know, those down smashes that he was getting KOs at like 75%, he needs to get that again.
Mm-hmm.
And does not need to let Eldin just sit there and camp him out. You don't want to sit there camping against Olimar.
Yeah, you don't want to pitch a Tet versus Olimar. You know, and another thing, too, Eldin really played the on-stage game much better than Seagulljoe did. But when it came to, like, how we're going to exploit each other's weaknesses, Seagulljoe had that man covered. Anytime he decided to, you know, recover a little bit too close to the ledge or a little bit up underneath, he would just throw out down smash and sweep him away. So both these two guys slowly but surely starting to figure each other out. Let's see what we get here for game number 2. Let's see if the adaptation is going to come out and show its face. Oh, my goodness.
Wait, was that damage? 34%.
34%. Two up smashes, man. Tossed out all the elements at him. My man Eldin looked like Captain Planet right now.
And just so you guys know, this is VG Bootcamp?
Yes. I believe so. Right, oh, no. This is 2G. I think this is 2GG. Okay, I don't know. Yeah, this is 2GG. The other one's VG Bootcamp, man. So we got two of the strongest streaming services on the planet right now, holding down Genesis 6 for you guys the right way. But my man Eldin right now holding down his lead even better. As you see right now, 53%. He's showing no signs of stopping anytime soon.
Okay, here we go. 69. He actually brought it back. That's good stuff to him. However, we have Seagulljoe at 81%. It's going to be tough. However, it's tough for both players because, again, see that back air? That was like an 81%. You got that back air to get a KO.
That's right.
Olimar could do the same thing with the up smash, especially with the purple Pikmin. And right now, 102%, you might be able to get the up throw with the blue Pikmin.
Mm-hmm. You know, he's really trying to play this low, this slow and steady. He's going to win the race game like we've seen in game number 1 and just really bank on maybe Seagulljoe, you know, overextending or getting a little bit too antsy when he decides to come in because he's tired of dealing with the Pikmin pressure.
Yeah.
But, you know, you got to try to get Seagulljoe off stage. Just as easy as you are abused out there, Seagulljoe's Wolf, you know, Wolf, phenomenal character, but off stage, history shows, pretty lackluster, you know what I mean?
Yeah, I agree. But right now, he's doing so well. He has 63% on Eldin, a lot of stage control that he has against him. And right now, Eldin having trouble getting that KO, even though Wolf is actually at 118%. But it seems like he's using a lot of, oh my God.
Oh my.
That was scary. Hey, I'm surprised it sent him like nowhere.
Yeah. Okay, whoa. I like the little recovery mix-up. Wants to try to reset the neutral, but we got to respect the dash attack. You know, Wolf, not short of any killing options, whether it's forward air, back air, I mean, back throw, you name it, man. He has himself covered at all times.
At all times, especially with the smash attacks that he does have. They have very little lag, so he's able to throw them out and, like, not be able to get punished. And that's why a lot of people are picking up Wolf. And as you see, the best player in Japan, Zach Ray, he's
Zach
here.
Ray. Absolutely. I had the opportunity to interview him, man. He's feeling very comfortable about his Wolf. He thinks he can do it. And I believe in him. And I trust in the Wolf. I'm not saying I'm a furry. But, man, if he wins this, K-Taro, I'm going to have to switch sides, right?
All right, you looking like a furry right now, I'm Mr. Saying Sonic Fox. You black, too. But here we go. That up throw.
I'd be black history, bro.
No, that's not purple. So he's not going to be able to take him off. And fair. Keeping him in the air, I feel that's a good choice against Olimar. Right now, he's still a whole stock ahead, having 39% on Olimar, so he's not going to be too worried.
That's right, man. You know, he's slowly but surely chipping his way back into this lead here, man. It hurts times, too, that Seagulljoe has a whole stock on him. But it goes back to what I said, though, at the end of the last game. If the beginning didn't look good for Seagulljoe, the end, he learned a couple things, and he's carrying it over here in the game number 2. And it's certainly starting to show, man. Okay? Tries to come in with the short hop forwarder. I like that. You know, of course, he gets quite a bit of damage off of that, but as you know, history has shown here with Eldin, he just does so well at playing away.
Yeah, that's true. And right now, okay, he gets some damage. However, it's still looking rough for him right now. He's at 83%. And against a character like Wolf, who gets KOs real early, especially after that neutral air, trying to go for the down smash, he's looking for that again. He knows he can get the up smash KO near the ledge or the down smash KO, especially at 92%.
That's right.
So all he has to do is play it safe, knock the Pikmin off him, and he's doing pretty good at that. So he just has to get a little close, and boom, smash attack.
As annoying as the Pikmin are, you can't forget that you have the lead. You know, of course, that's Olimar's med. He's going to keep pelting. He's going to keep throwing them at you. And chances are, with the way Eldin's been playing here, he's not really going off stage. So with that in mind, you know that you can recover for virtually scot-free. You know that if you continue to control the pacing of the match with your neutral special too, you'll be in a good position here towards the end of this. But, I mean, right now, you on the other end of that, you can't give Eldin that much time to figure things out, too.
Yeah, exactly. You don't want him to be able to download you or get that one read that would come to an up smash KO with the purple Pikmin. He doesn't have the purple Pikmin out right now. However, Wolf, 117%. He's looking for that possible grab, and that was it right there. However, he couldn't get it. But again, Seagulljoe always looking for that up smash read. He knows if they do a regular get up or a roll, that up smash read will be able to get either one. And he has such a huge lead, he does not care. He's like, oh, I got it. I don't care.
That up smash definitely has the scoop and the sprinkles, dog. It'll get you. Once more neutral specials push him off stage. And he's just trying to play it safe. You know, before we've seen a lot of down smashes at the ledge, like you talked about before. Now he's just looking for something a little bit more on the simpler side of things. You know, possibly a down tilt into, you know, it could be a back air, or possibly a down tilt into a nair at this percent. But, you know, right now, Eldin Wright has some rage on his behalf, 144%. If he can get the right combination of Pikmin, the purple, possibly a white and a blue one, things aren't going to be looking too good here for Seagulljoe. He's going to have to try to close this out real quick.
Yeah, I feel like Seagulljoe might be looking for that back air. However, he's just chilling there right now.
Yeah.
Only 3%, doesn't have any Pikmin on him. I feel like he's not rushing. 156%. He can almost do a back throw KO really soon. So
yeah.
He knows if he gets him up to like 170, 180, he doesn't even have to approach that hard. But again, 6%. Olimar does not need to approach, but Olimar is approaching, so it's kind of scary.
Man, look at the purple. Look at the way he's dancing with the purple. Oh, okay, there's the dash attack. Okay, there's the dash attack.
Able to get the KO. Good stuff coming out by Seagulljoe, making the first game look like a fluke, but we don't know.
Yeah, man, sometimes you got to remind him why you're one of the best Wolves in Brawl, dog.
Yeah, you got to remind him. I feel like he could. That's crazy. I think Seagulljoe towards the end of Brawl was the best Wolf.
Yes.
And the Wolf is better in this game, so now it's harder to be the best Wolf. You have Zach Gray, we have Tweaky's casually playing Wolf, we have a couple other people.
You got Leffen too, you know. Leffen's making waves over across the season. I know he's here this weekend too, probably playing Wolf as well. So it's a lot of Wolves in the house. Like we said, man, if you're a furry, it's a good weekend to be a furry here.
All right, I want to see how Seagulljoe could do, but again, he has to take out Eldin. This is first round of pools, struggling a little, and right now it's Eldin's counter pick. So it looked like he picked, I don't know if it was Battlefield. He's going to say Olimar.
Okay.
What character do you mean?
I play a little Mii Gunner and Link, but you know, two characters that still do semi-decently on Battlefield, kind of like, you know, Olimar in this equation. You know, I foresee in this match, and I'm not Nostradamus by any means, but I foresee him, you know, getting Seagulljoe off of his feet, and then of course, just platform abuse all over the place, just really taking all that landing coverage away from him.
All right, let's see if he can do it.
As you see, started up early too, man. He's like, look, if you get up on that top platform, I'm not going to let you come back down.
All right, right now we have 10% already on him. Okay, got that dash attack somehow after that down throw, but Seagulljoe looking like Sheik. That's the thing. People say, like, Wolf is the new Sheik. Like, all the Sheik mains should play Wolf.
Yeah, pretty much, man. Except, you know, obviously this character can actually kill. Yeah. Unlike Sheik.
true.
Right, man. But, you know, a much more even start than what we've seen in the last few games here. You know, Eldin right now really struggling here to get his offense started up. You know, with the addition of these platforms too, you know, Seagulljoe has a bit more, he has a few more options in terms of mobility. He can kind of dance around a little bit better.
Oh, wow. Oh, I like that by Seagulljoe. He's actually putting a lot more pressure on Eldin than before. I know in the first few games he was like hanging back, like, what are you going to do? Mm-hmm. I don't mind it in the second game when he had like a stock lead, but when he had where he was losing and he's trying to do that in the first game, I feel like that was not the option. However, purple Pikmin's out. Let's watch out for the F smash.
You got to watch out, man. We're starting to see Seagulljoe not do a lot of neutral get ups anymore. We're starting to see a lot of rolling because he's trying to outmaneuver that forward smash. I really hope Eldin's not preconditioning him into something because, as we know, you know, Eldin, very, very intelligent player. You know, there's a method to the madness that is Olimar. He's just not throwing Pikmin aimlessly.
Yeah, it's true. And right now he's rolling a lot. That's the scary part. When you roll, you put yourself in a defensive position, especially when you want to get that. You need to be aggressive. You need to be able to try to go for that KO option, and he needs to not go for rolls too much. And right now he's suffering because of it, because he's playing too defensive.
Most certainly is. Oh, okay, kind of faked him out a little bit. I think he kind of gave off the false sense of security that he's going to go out and try to go for like a back air stage spike. Actually decides to just stay it at the ledge.
Well, if he had gotten that down smash, that would have been it. Okay, actually, it doesn't matter. I think this is actually it. Three stocks to one stock. Seagulljoe 120. I would not be surprised if Seagulljoe was able to get at least 20% on him, and there goes 10 already.
That's right, man. Eldin definitely on life support here. Let's see what he's going to have to do to turn this thing around. He's starting to become a little bit more aggressive, you know. Not seeing as many Pikmin being thrown. He's deciding to come up and look for a grab. The closer he gets, though, the easier it is for his Pikmin to be blown away by Wolf's neutral special. Yeah, what the heck?
Yeah, he gave like 50% with Wolf's neutral special. There's a lot of people who complain about this attack, where you just press the B attack like this, and boom, you'll get like 70, 50%. And that's the issue that Eldin's having. I feel like Seagulljoe realized, hey, let me just go for this. This will work.
Yeah, you know, the Olimar, Pikmin Olimar mates are starting to get a little taste of their own medicine, is basically what it is. You know, not saying that they have a projectile quite as good as Wolf's. But, you know, just when it comes to, you know, pacing and obviously using your projectiles to kind of annoy your opponent, I think that's something that the Olimar mains are very good at.
Yeah, I agree.
And so, obviously, Wolf is kind of comprised of that same formula here in Smash Ultimate.
Wow, I feel like Seagulljoe has figured out this matchup in this one set, saying, hey, I'm just going to throw out this neutral B, you can't approach me, and then finally when you are able to approach me, when I want to approach you, I just do some attacks and you can't handle it.
Uh-oh.
There you go. Is he going to land?
Okay. It's the nice. I like that neutral air. Okay, just retreating. Doesn't want to stay towards center stage anymore. He knows that that's where Eldin likes to be at all times.
Yep. 149%. I feel like Seagulljoe might go crazy off the stage. Oh no. Woo! Too much Pikmin. Is he gonna go crazy? He's gonna play it safe.
Uh-oh.
Oh my gosh.
You see how far he was from the ledge, man? I wouldn't even.